The HERC2 allele could affect the promoter of OCA2 because the genes are so close together, or the allele could alter the HERC2 protein so that it interacts with OCA2 and directly blocks its action. Now, the other options aren't possible here because they change the coding region of OCA2, but we know that the mutation is within the HERC2 gene, which is beside OCA2. So this is kind of a tough question. It's really putting together a lot of the knowledge we've talked about up to this point about coding regions and non-coding regions and possible interactions among different proteins, as well as their locations on the chromosome. If the two genes are beside each other, then alleles changing the coding region of OCA2 aren't really possible because we're not saying they're overlapping, they're beside each other. And so the two options that are left are that perhaps we know that non-coding regions, the regulatory regions of the OCA2 gene, surround the gene, and they can even be thousands of base pairs away. So a mutation in the HERC2 gene could actually be in one of the non-coding regulatory regions of OCA2 that reduces its transcription. And the other alternative is that we actually change the HERC2 protein itself, and the HERC2 protein physically interacts with the OCA2 protein elsewhere in the cell, and it inhibits or reduces its activity. Both of those are plausible.